The person who is unable to make his mind get absorbed in the Nirakara Swarupa has to take to prayers. And why prayers? To ward off the earlier duritas. And after such prayers, he has to take to vichara. What vichara? Maya, Jiva, Jiva and Ishvara. How it is to be conducted was demonstrated. But problem many a times continues. In spite of this, knowledge is not possible. What is the diagnosis? There are some obstructions. There are some pratibandhas. And invariably the pratibandhas may be, in the next stanza I will be seeing, because of the past, or because of improper inquiry. It can be because of the past. What is the past? Duritas. So that means results of adverse actions pose obstruction presently, that is there, which has to be removed by what? Only prayers. Only prayers to Ishvara can remove them. So therefore it says pratibandhasya bahulya. These obstructions are galore. So therefore what is to be done? One has to pray again to Ishvara with the mantras, as two mantras that are 4th chapter, 12th and 13th mantras, Yo Deva Ityadi. By this, repeatedly one has to take to prayers. Because in the prayers you invoke the Ishvara, as a result of that, it has got the capacity to nullify the past sins, so that duritas can be nullified. Let us see what are those two mantras. Yo devanam prabhavaschodbhavascha vishvadhiko rudro maharshi hiranyagarbham pashyata jayamanaghyum sano buddhya shubhaya sayunattu. Yaha, this is the 12th mantra. Yaha devanam prabhavah. The one who is the prabhava. Prabhava here is Prabhavati asmat iti prabhava, the source, origin, the one from whom devas are born. Because devas are something who are endowed with such power and might. So even they are born of whom? Prabhavascha, udbhavascha, their growth, glory. The glories of devas are because of this Parameshwara only. So who is that? Vishwadipaha or Vishwadhikaha. The one with Vishwadhipaha, two of the readings are there. Vishwadhipaha, we have seen this. The one with the overlord of entire creation. And Vishwadhika means one who transcends the creation. One who is independent of the creation. So Vishwadhika. Rudraha. So Rudraha means Sarva Dukkha Nivarakaha. One who dispels all the sorrows. When all the sorrows can be removed, when is it possible to get rid of all the sorrows? I think sleep, is it not? When? See, sorrows have to be ended in such a way that there is no occasion for sorrow to be born again. When is it possible? Atma jnana. In Brahma jnana only. Ajnana has to be removed. Sleep is not a solution because jnana continues. So therefore, so Rudraha, Sarva Dukkha Nivarakaha, by conferring the knowledge of Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana. There is a saying, Jnanam Maheshwara Adichche, Arogyam Bhaskara Adichche. So, if you want health, invoke whom? Surya Narayana. If you want knowledge, Maheshwara Icche. Sano Buddhya yes, Rudra Maharshi. And he was, you see, who is the first created one? Prathamajaha. Hiranyagarbha. Even before Hiranyagarbha was born, he used to exist. Hiranyagarbham, meaning of this, we have seen the context of Skanda 52. So Hiranyagarbham, Pashyata Jayamanam. So he saw the Hiranyagarbha who was born. So who was born means, what does it mean? So one who was even before the Hiranyagarbha was born. So Hiranyagarbham, Pashyata. Pashyata here is Apashyat or Pashyati. So sees means to show that Parameshwara was even before Hiranyagarbha came into existence. Jayamanam. Now prayer is Saha. So Saha Rudraha Parameshwara. So Naha to us. What we should do? Shubhaya Buddhya Sanyunaktu. Sanyunaktu, Sanyojayatu. May he unite us with, means may he bestow on us what? Shubha Buddhi. Shubha Buddhi, Shubham Jnanam. Buddhi here is Jnana. What is that knowledge? Shubha. What is that Shubha knowledge? Atma Vidya, Brahma Vidya. May he confer upon us the Brahma Vidya. Further, next mantra is 4.13. Yo devanamadipo yasmin loka adhishritaha ya ishe asya dipadash chatushpada kasmai devaya havishavideva. Yaha, the one who is devanamadipataha, overlord of the devas, because these presiding deities themselves have got some power and he is above them, devanamadipataha. And yasmin, in whom lokaha adhishritaha. Lokas, all the entire creation, all the lokas, words 14 lokas, adhishritaha means ashritaha. So they are centered in whom? Yaha, which Parameshwara? Asya dvipadas chatushpadaha ishe. Ishe means overlord, means he is the overlord of asya, of these. What are those? Dvipadas chatushpadaha, literally means, dvipadaha means biped. Chatushpada is quadruped. We are biped. Achha, okay. So, two-legged fellows, okay? So that is there. So means, and it is vipadaha chatushpada, upalakshana for entire creation, not only biped and quadruped as such. So they say, when a person is a single, he is biped. After marriage, quadruped. And then, when the first child is born, shatpada. So like that it continues after. Then centipede and millipede. Okay. So, Dharpari says, Dhipadat means, it's upalakshana for entire creation. Ishe is our Lord. Kasmai devaya havisha vidhema. So, here kasmai is a very peculiar word. Actually it is from kam. What is kam? Kam is sukham, or kam also can be water. Keshavam patitam drishtva. No, don't do that. Keshavam patitam drishtva pandava harsha nirbhara kauravaha vadanti ha keshava. I hope, is it possible? You must have understood some meaning. Keshavam patitam drishtva, having seen Keshava fallen, pandavaha harsha nirbharaha. Pandavas were rejoicing. Kauravaha rudanti. Kauravas were crying. Ha Keshava, ayo Keshava, is it ever possible? Kauravas is very happy. So Keshava, what is that? The pun is around the word Keshava. What is the Keshava? Keshava is Krishna, but here it is Keshavam. What is K? Kam also means water, so therefore Saptami Vibhakti of Kam is K. K in water or the pond, in that pond happened Shavam Patitam Drishtva. Some dead body fell down. Pandavaha frogs. Pandavas are frogs. Pandavaha Harsha Nirbhara, they are happy because when it rots they can eat. Kauravaha crows. Kauravas, they were there on the thing. So they were crying. Ha Keshava, ha Keshava, it was outside, they would have eaten it. So now ayo, it is up. So anyway, kam can mean water, kam can also mean sukha. So therefore, this is a chandasa prayoga. It is kam and chaturthi vibhakti is kaya. So kaya means sukha swarupaya, ananda swarupaya. So that will be. So how kasmaya has come? It is a chandasa prayoga. A Vedic you said. So kaya means ananda rupaya, and that smai is because of chandasa. So kas ananda rupaya devaya, this parameshwara with anrupa havishavi deva, we offer the oblation, we adore him with the oblation. So therefore, so like this, if the mantras one has to pray Ishwara, so it applies to all the prayers. So for example, this is the Vedic prayer. Nowadays, Vishnu Sahasranama, Shiva Sahasranama, Lalita Sahasranama, all these do help to wipe out the Durita. But what should we show there? The intention must be clear. Otherwise, you may chant the same thing to get this result and that result, then it will be utilized for the encashment of the, for whatever that you want. So no, it should be for Chitta Shuddhi, Ishwara Arpana Buddhi. So therefore it should be in just to pray the Lord because that is glory. So this way. So now these pratibandhas are there. So the what are there? The obstructions are there. So what is to be done for that? So these are like this. The person who is vichara kushalaha, adept in inquiry and shravana, means his ascertainment of tatparya nishchaya of shastra is very correct, and yet he doesn't have the knowledge. It only means there are past pratibandhas, adrishta pratibandhas. So they have to be overcome by the prayers. Now there may be person who has not taken to proper inquiry. So vichara is not done properly. That is drishta pratibandha. It is obstruction seen here, not earlier one. So therefore that person has to take to proper inquiry. So therefore, and again, what is that proper inquiry also will be dealt with in mantras 14 to 22 of chapter 4 afterwards. Whatever that is, yaha, adrishta pratibandha, obstruction. Obstruction in what? Gaining the knowledge. And it is because of adrishta. What is adrishta? na drishtam adrishtam. So he refers to past karma phalas. So here punya will not come in picture because it is a pratibandha, therefore papa only will come in picture. So other also it is said adrishta is punya and duradrishta is papa, that is that, but adrishta is both papa and punya. So here context is such that it poses pratibandha, means it is an papa and not punya. Punya also are of two types. One bhoga punya for bhogas, other one is for adhyatmika sadhanas as such. So that depends on the attitude and the hankering of the individual. Yaha adrishta pratibandha, so whatever that is pratibandha, obstruction, impediment, which is on account of past papas, tam, that pratibandham, bhajanena nivartya, nivartya, having warded off, having nullified, by what? Bhajanena, by bhajana. What is bhajana? Invoking the Lord. Now this bhajana is also, singing also can be bhajana. Nowadays bhajana means what? Singing the songs, etc. That is true. Actually, this type of congregational bhajan was introduced by Guru Nanak. Before that it was not so. Guru Nanak had introduced this congregational bhajan, means all together singing. It has got a very good effect, very effective as such. So it was by Guru Nanak it was started. But here bhajana is invoking, as told earlier, the mantras, etc. or whatever that is, even Puranic ways you can take to. So bhajanena nivartya, having dispelled. Then yaha drishtaha pratibandha, so the other one which is drishta pratibandha, obstruction which on account of some factor here, what is that? Inquiry is not conducted properly. Vichara means exposure to the teaching, that is exposure to proper teaching is not there. Now teaching also has to be proper, otherwise anything can be there. Sampradaya will be made as asampradaya and asampradaya will be treated as sampradaya. So that is not there, it should be proper. So that's why, see, all these are very difficult. That's what you have to do is raise your arms up. You have to surrender Ishwara only, more so in Kali Yuga. So that is that. So the wrong things are parading as the right thing, and right things are condemned as wrong things as such. So therefore Ishwara only has to come to our rescue. So therefore the bhajana etc. was told. So yaha drishtaha pratibandha, the one that is the drishta pratibandha is because of lack of proper vichara, inquiry. Tam, that pratibandham, punaha further vicharena jaye. So it should be, jayat means conquered, means it should be removed by jayat, means twofold pursuit. One prayer to remove the adrishta pratibandha, then proper inquiry, vichara, proper shravana to get the tatparya nishchaya. So that vicharena jaye punaha, by further inquiry one has to get rid of that drishta pratibandha. Some more clues to inquire into the swarupa are being given now from stanza 14 to stanza 22, except one mantra in between.
Come on.
So this Atma is of such nature. What is it? Sukshme bhyaha paramanu bhyaha api ati sukshma. Sukshma, subtle. The most subtle that we can conceive of, say paramanu, atoms or whatever that is there. So, of course, atoms, paramanus conceived by our earlier sages is different from your present atom as such. Anyway, but one thing is common, the most subtle thing that you can conceive of, so paramanu bhyaha. Or among the elements which is the most subtle, akasha. So akasha. So therefore, sukshmebhya paramanubhya api, then even the most subtle paramanus or these atoms, you say. And what does subtle means? More the subtle, less the gunas. Gunas. See, earth is most gross. It has got shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. Water, little less because gandha is not there. Fire, little more subtle. So why? Gandha and rasa are not there. Air, form also is not there, shabda, this, gandha and rasa also are not there. So akasha, none of these, their sound only is there, other four are not there. So subtle. And now, this Atma, even free from shabda, the sound, so therefore it is the most subtle. Sukshmebhya paramanubhya ati ati sukshmaha, the most subtle ayamatma. So what happens? Bahirmukhaihi nalakshyate. Nalakshyate is not cognized by who? Who are bahirmukhaha? What is meant by bahirmukhaha? Extrovert. Where is that bahirmukhatvam? Vishayabhimukhatvam. Those whose minds are engrossed in vishaya, what type of vrittis will be there, thoughts will be there? Shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. These vrittis make the mind gross because they themselves, these vishaya themselves are gross. See, what is meant by knowledge? You have to have a direct cognition of Atma Swarupa. What you mean by direct cognition? Your cognition must be exactly in accordance with Atma. Suppose you want to verify this is candy or alum. Both look alike. Is this candy or alum? However great expert you may be in touching and finding, etc., it will not be possible. You have to make use of proper pramana. And what is that pramana? Not simply pratyaksha, seeing also is pratyaksha. Rasa pratyaksha you have to take. You have to take the rasa pratyaksha because that only can tell you what it is. And then what happens? Then you see, pratyaksha taste, that taste is exactly in accordance with the whether it is candy or alum. So therefore, at that time have you got experience or not? Experience of what? That candy or alum means in accordance with its nature. You know? Same apply. This is applicable to pratyaksha, where the thing is available for direct perception. Same thing applies to aparoksha. See, same thing applies to aparoksha. So aparoksha, jnana. There also, this is the principle. What is that? Just as pratyaksha vastu is directly available for perception. Why? Siddhatva, the right, available rightly, the right in front of you, available. Likewise, aparoksha vastu also being nitya siddha and anubhava swarupa is available for anubhava. Presently, is it available for anubhava or not? No. You as I is available for anubhava or not? Are you experiencing yourself or not? Yes. I am the one who is sitting in Shravana class, so 25% I can understand, 75% goes over. Sorry. So, okay. So I think I understood. I think I have got knowledge, I think so. So, but that is paroksha. You know why? See, you can't deny your experience of yourself. Whatever you as an individual, bundles of whatever things that you are experiencing moment by moment, but it is not the experience of your true nature, because that experience is not in accordance with your true nature. On the contrary, it is topsy-turvy. Why? You are experiencing yourself mixed with what you are not. Adhyaropa is there. So therefore, that experience has to be, now it is ayathartha. It has to be yathartha. And yathartha means what? Exactly like Atma Swarupa. What is required? How is it possible? Who can do it? Your same antakarana mind can do it. Why it can't do presently? Because it is preoccupied with bahya vishayas. It is bahya dhihi. Then what it should happen? So it has to get rid of this bahya dhitva, bahya vishaya. So that antakarana, which is free from all this, is can serve to display you the replica of your Swarupa. Just as you see your face in the mirror, so that day it can help you. So that in the case say, so bahirmukhaihi nalakshate. So this is it. That is why Vedanta emphasizes at every step the necessity of Shuddha Antakarana. Necessity of Shuddha Antakarana. And what you mean by Shuddha Antakarana? Shanta Antakarana. The Shanta Antakarana is the fit receptacle to display or reflect Atma Swarupa in its true nature, like your face in the mirror. Any other vritti is coming, or lack of ekagrata distorts the Swarupa. So there the knowledge is not there. So mere ascertainment is paroksha jnana. So therefore, so atiswa bahirmukhaihi na lakshate is not cognized by extrovert people. So sadhat atma saha ayam atma svataha. That atma svataha means svayam, itself. There is it. Vishvam vyapya avatishtate. It is there. Vishvam vyapya, having pervaded the entire creation, it remains. In how? Entire creation is superimposed in this Paramatma Swarupa, Atma Swarupa. And the same one, and again they say, it is like this. In mantra it is like this. Sukshmati sukshmam kalilasya madhe. That which is the most subtle, kalilasya madhe. Kalila is here, avidya and its formidable karya. And it abides in the entire creation. Vishvasya srashtaram, creator of the entire creation. Aneka rupam, that which has all the rupas. Vishvasya ekam pariveshtitaram, the one who pervades the entire creation. Jnatva, having known Shivam, the Shivam. Shantim atyantam eti. Atyantam shantim eti. What is atyanta shanti? Moksha. So one gets Swarupa, abidance in the Swarupa. Further, in the 15th mantra it said, Saha eva, we are the same Shiva, Atma Swarupa. Kale means sthiti kale, at the time of the sustenance. Bhuvanasya gopta is the protector, sustainer of entire creation. Vishwadhipaha, so one is overlord of the creation. Sarva bhute, so the one who is abiding in all the beings. Yasmin yukta. The Parameshwara is the one in whom, yasmin, in whom, Brahmarshayaha Devata Sayuktaha, the minds of Brahmarshis and the Devatas, deciding duties, are Yuktaha, Yuktaha, Samahitaha, are absorbed, means Brahmarshis and Devatas meditate on this Paramatma Swarupa and their minds are totally absorbed in the Swarupa. That means they are in Samadhi, through Samadhi they know the Parameshwara. Tam evam jnatva. So having known this Paramatma in this manner, in its true nature, so this one who protects, sustains the jagat at the time of Stiti, etc. So evam jnatva. What is the result? Mrityupashan chinati. So one snaps off the bonds of mrityu. Mrityu means death, means samsara, mrityu rupa samsara. One gets relieved from the bondage of samsara. So this is now explained in Skanda 76. Jagatah palanenayam asti tyadau vibhudhyatam ब्रह्मर्षयो देवताश्च योगे नैतं विजानते अन्वय आदौ आदौ जगतः पालनेन अयम् अस्ति इति विबुध्यताम् आदौ जगतः पालनेन अयम् अस्ति इति विबुध्यताम् ब्रह्मर्षयः देवताश्च एतं योगेन विजानते ब्रह्मर्षयः देवताश्च एतं योगेन विजानते फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो फॉर सर्टन दैट द ब्रह्म द परमेश्वर डज एग्जिस्ट सो इफ दैट इटसेल्फ इज नॉट क्लियर But the further pursuit doesn't take place at all. Now, a reasoning is given to ascertain that there is Parameshwara, so there is Brahma. So how can you say that? Just look around the world. This world consists of beings. What type of beings? They say 84 lakhs of species. Comprising from Hiranyagarbha onwards, the topmost onwards to any living creation, innumerable devatas, then human beings, animals, birds and varieties of these are there with all diversity. So if such a vast creation runs and if there is a perfect orderliness in the creation, it automatically presumes that there must be a lawgiver. There must be one who controls the world, regulates the world, and the one who controls the world of such diversity and such magnitude should necessarily have the all knowledge about the creation. Not only that, he should have all the capacities to control, to create, sustain and destroy entire creation. Means he must necessarily be that creator principle. Must necessarily be sarvajnaha sarvashaktiman. So in this manner one can ascertain the existence of Parameshwara first and then inquire and discover the Swarupa and by constant meditation make the mind get absorbed in the Swarupa. So here is a adav, therefore adav in the beginning. What is to be done? Jagataha palanena. By observing this palana, protection, the sustenance of the entire jagat comprising devatiriyagadi, bhuveda bhinnasya se vichitrasya jagataha. This vichitra jagat, multifold diverse jagat comprising devatas and animals, human beings, etc. So, jagatasya. So what is the palanena? I am means this Ishvara. And what type of Ishvara is? Sarvajnaha, Sarvashaktiman. I am Ishvara. asti is there, without which this sustenance of the jagat is just next to impossible. Asti iti vidujyatam, may be known for certain. So in this manner, one has to ascertain the existence of Ishvara, and that Ishvara is the one on whom Brahmarshis and Devatas meditate and make their mind absorbed and directly cognize the Brahma Swarupa, Paramatma Swarupa. Brahmarshayaha Devatascha. Brahmarshis. What is Brahmarshis? Who has got the Brahma Jnana. So, the one who has got the Brahma Jnana, whose mind is absorbed in the Brahma Swarupa. Devatascha, the great Devatas, like Indra, Varuna, Brihaspati, so Yamaraja, so all such Devatas, Devatascha. Etam means this Parameshwaram, who is the palaka of the entire creation. So etam yogena vijanate, know him. How? By yoga. What is that yoga? Yogastu citta vritti nirodaha. The mind wherein all the vrittis are restrained and the mind has got absorbed in the Swarupa. As told in Bhagavad Gita, 13th chapter, Dhyane nātmani paśyanti kechidātmānam ātmanā. By dhyana, what is that dhyana there? The dhyana wherein the mind is totally withdrawn from all the bāhya viṣayas and it has been made as brahmākāra, ātmākāra, totally absorbed in the sarūpa. So that yogena by samādhi vijānate, so they know. So therefore, this Ishvara has to be known like this. And one who knows his Sarupa gets freed from the samsara sagara. Same thing is further explained in the next mantra, 4th chapter, 16th mantra. Kṛtāparam mandamivāti sukṣmam nyātvā śivam sarva bhūteshu gūḍham. Sarva bhūteshu gūḍham śivam nyātvā. Having known the Shiva, here Shiva is not just Kailasadhipati Shiva, so here the Paramatma Sarupa, Brahma Sarupa, Parameshwara, so Shiva, who is he? He is the most essence, that means he is the essence of entire creation, like the cream as it were in the milk. What is the cream as it were in the milk? So in the, in the milk there is the butter, it is all pervaded in the milk. A person who knows how to extract the butter takes the proper steps like curling, making the curd, churning, then butter comes. Butter is heated further, it becomes ghee, and even in that ghee, at the top, one layer settles down, it is called as manda. See, liquid hot ghee is suddenly cooled, so there forms a layer on the top of the ghee, which is very tasteful. Ghee itself is tasteful. So then this is this cream which settles on the top of the ghee is called manda. It is much more tasteful. Of course, don't try in these days of cholesterol. That is a different problem. But it is very tasteful. So therefore, ghritātparam manda viva. So ghritātparam above the ghee. So mandam viva. Manda means that cream, that essence, like that. Ati sukshmam shivam nyatva, having known the Shiva, with the most subtle, the very basis of entire creation. So there is a sarva bhuteshu gudham, one who abides in all the beings. Vishvasya ekam pariveshtitarat, the one who is pervading the entire creation. Nyatva devam, having known directly, having cognized directly this Parameshwara, mucchate sarva pashaihi, and gets free from all the bondages, gets free, gets moksha. That is not explained. Kshire ghrita nimittam yat saram taddhima tekshate tata vritti nirodhinya sukshmam vastu dhekshatam. Kshire anvaya, kshire air, sarvatra vartamanam ghrita nimittam yat saram tad dhimata
एड यथा कंटिन्यू ईक्षते तथा वृत्ति निरोधिन्या धिया सूक्ष्मम वस्तु ईक्षताम धिया ईक्षताम दीक्षता तथा वृत्ति निरोधिन्या धिया सूक्ष्मम वस्तु ईक्षताम। वंस अगेन क्षीरे एड सर्वत्र वर्तमानम कंटिन्यू घृत निमित्तम यत् सारम तद् तद् धीमता धीमता एड यथा ईक्षते तथा वृत्ति निरोधिन्या वृत्ति निरोधिन्या धिया सूक्ष्मम वस्तु सूक्ष्मम वस्तु कंटिन्यू ईक्षता। जस्ट एड क्षीरे इन द मिल्क सर्वत्र वर्तमानम पदम दट इज देयर इन एंड थ्रू द एंटायर मिल इन द घृत निमित्तम सो ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ द घृत यत् सारम सो मीन्स इन द मिल आफ्टर गेटिंग द बटर एंड वी हैव मेड द घी घृत निमित्तम यत् सारम वट एवर द क्रीम वट एवर द एसेंस इन टर्म्स ऑफ वट यू हैव सीन ऑलरेडी हियर मंडम द क्रीम सेटलिंग ऑन द टॉप ऑफ द लिक्विड घी सो यत्सारम तत् हू कैन नो दिस धीमता यथा ईक्षते कैन बी नोन ओनली बाय विवेक इज अदरवाइज अ ले पर्सन विल से वेर इज द घी इन दिस वट इज देयर इज ओनली मिल्क ओनली नो द पर्सन हु नोस द नेक ऑफ प्रोड्यूसिंग द घी फ्रॉम द मिल्क बाय प्रॉपर प्रोसेस सो ही नोस दैट पर्सन इज कॉल्ड एज धीमान मीन्स विवेकी हु नोस द थिंग सो धीमता ईक्षते इसी ले पर्सन A child not know this, but a person who knows the process certainly know that manda is there in this very ghee only. Likewise, in and through the entire creation, one may not be able to directly cognize the Brahma Swarupa, Parameshwara Swarupa, but who knows the process of discovering this Brahma in and through entire creation. So how do you know? तथा इन द सेम मैनर वृत्ति निरोधिन्या धिया बाई धी बाई द इंटलेक्ट बाई द अंतकरण विच हैज टेकन टू वृत्ति निरोध वृत्ति निरोधिनी धी धी अंतकरण वेर इन ऑल वृत्तिज आर निरुद्ध आर कंट्रोल मीन्स दे आर टर्मिनेटेड अर्लियर डिस्क्राइब एज सूक्ष्म धीहि तदर्थात वृत्ति निरोधिन्या धिया मीन्स बाय सूक्ष्म सूक्ष्मया धिया धी वेरिन वृत्ति निरोध इज देयर मीन्स द माइंड अंतकरण विच हैज अकम्प्लिश्ड द समाधि समाधि इन द आत्मस्वरूप सो वृत्ति निरोधिन्या धिया सूक्ष्मम वस्तु The very most subtle vastu, vastu here Brahma, most subtle in the sense, sarvatra gudham sukshma vastu paramatma swarupam. The sukshma vastu which is sarvatra gudham, which is abiding in and through everything which itself is paramatma swarupa. So by such vritti nirodhinya dhiya sukshmam vastu ikshatam, may it be directly cognized. With such process, it can be known. A lay person may not be able to know this Brahma Swarupa, Parameshwara Swarupa, though it is in and through the entire creation. But who knows the process of withdrawing the mind from the preoccupation in the entire creation and making it niruddha, free from all the vrittis, is capable of knowing this Brahma in terms of direct cognition, because in such वृत्ति निरोधिनी धीहि और समाहित धीहि और कॉल्ड है सूक्ष्म धीहि परमेश्वर स्वरूप परमात्म स्वरूप ब्रह्म स्वरूप गेट्स रिफ्लेक्टेड इन इट्स ट्रू नेचर विदाउट द ट्रेस ऑफ एनी अध्यस्त अध्यारोपित विषय और द जगत इन दिस मैनर इट हैज टू बी नो सो अगेन This Brahma-sarupa, Paramatma-sarupa is such that there cannot be any illustration for this. No drishtanta is possible because it is totally free from the adhyasta prapancha. As Mandukya Upanishad described, prapanchopashamam. It is totally free from entire jagat. Brihadaranyaka ascertains as neti neti, the one in whom none of these created things which can be known as idam, 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 this, 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 none of these exist in that. So that is what is now being described in the 78th based on mantras 18 and 19 of 4th chapter Shvetashtra. There it runs like this. Yada atamaha tat na diva na ratrihi na sat na ca asat Shivaha eva kevalam. This is from 18th mantra, 4th chapter. Then further from 19. Nainam urdham na tiryam cha, na tiryam cham na vadhe parijagradhat, etc. Further also it is na tasya pratima asti. 19th mantra, 4th chapter. It's like this. Yada, when atamaha. So when a seeker has become atamaha, atamaha means free from tama, the darkness, your darkness of ignorance. So when there is no ignorance means when the ignorance of the seeker is dispelled by Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana. That is what is said here. Yada atamaha tat. In that state of Brahma Swarupa means by yoga, when the mind is absorbed in the Brahma Swarupa, then na diva, there is no day, na ratri, there is no night, na sat, na cha, asat, neither bhava or abhava, neither the relative existence of a thing created in the world or absence of a thing. For example, microphone is, that isness, sat, that isness, existence, the relative existence of a microphone after being produced. Suppose apple is not there on my palm, there is no apple. In the sense, absence of the apple, the non-existence of the apple is also about a thing called apple created in the world. This bhava, abhava, relative existence and non-existence of the things that are created in the world, na sat, na cha, asat, none of these are there. It is the lakshana of our entire creation. That means in that state wherein the mind is totally absorbed in the Swarupa, nothing belonging to the creation is cognized because it is all falsely attributed. And that being the case, none of these are there. What is there then remaining? Shivaha eva kevalaha. Only Shiva is there. Without Shiva, Paramatma Swarupa, Brahma alone is there. Nothing else. And it doesn't have na enam urdham na tiryancha na madhe parijagrabhat. Means nothing can be caught. Means neither the above nor the below nor the horizontal in terms of all the quarters. Nothing is there. Means no creation is there, no directions, no nothing is there. So only Shiva and Shiva alone is there. Again, it is something. Na tasya pratima asti. There is no parallel to it. There is no drishtanta to it. Listen. Illustration to Brahma can never be, because to illustrate something you have to take something from the creation, and Brahma is totally free from creation. Prapanchopashama, there is no possibility whatsoever of so giving anything as drishtanta. Even though in Vedanta we do find many times certain illustrations like that. Brahma is like Akasha. We should know here only certain aspect of Akasha is taken, and Akasha cannot be equated to Brahma. For example, when you say Brahma is like Akasha, space, it only means it is all pervasive like space, it is subtle like space, nothing beyond that, because Akasha is something created, Brahma is not created. So this way, all illustrations given are short of the Swarupa, but they do highlight one or two aspects of the nature of Brahma. To that extent, they are helpful in terms of teaching, describing what the Swarupa of Brahma can be. So that is now explained now here in stanza 78.
दिवारात्रिस्तमश्चान्यद् यस्मिन् नास्ति न किञ्चन नोर्ध्वं न तिर्यक्तद्वस्तु न दृष्टान्तोऽस्य विद्यते.
अन्वय
यस्मिन् इफ यू वांट संधि लाइक दिस रात्रिः तमः च अन्यत् यस्मिन् न अस्ति. सेकेंड लाइन तिर्य तद् वस्तु नाटे अन्वय यस्मिन् दिवारात्रिः तमश्च अन्यत् न अस्ति न किञ्चन न ऊर्ध्वं न तिर्य तद्वस्तु अस्य दृष्टान्तः न विद्यते. अस्य दृष्टान्तः न विद्यते. वन्स अगेन यस्मिन् दिवा रात्रिः तमः च अन्य न अस्ति न किञ्चन न ऊर्ध्वं न तिर्य तद्वस्तु अस्य दृष्टान्तः न विद्यते. अस्य दृष्टान्तः न विद्यते. यस्मिन् इन् हूम् इन् हूम् दिवारात्रिः दिवा दे रात्रि नाइट तमः च अज्ञान इग्नोरेंस एंड अन्यत् अन्यत् व्हाट इज दैट भाव आरोप अभाव आरोप रिलेटिव एक्जिस्टेंस और रिलेटिव एब्सेंस ऑफ समथिंग. Nothing from the creation is there, means it is totally free from the entire creation. Nothing jana, nothing else is there. No urdham, no above, no tiryak. So, no above means no below, no tiryak, no quarter tiryak. Tad vastu means that. What is that? The one that is free from ignorance and the entire creation described in terms of no day, no night, etc. So tat, that one is what? Vastu. Vastu means Brahma. So that is Brahma. Asya, asya means of this Brahma, asya Brahmanaha, drishtantaha, an illustration, navidyate is not there, because to give an illustration, you have to take something from the creation. But the Brahma is totally free from creation, and nothing from the creation can be equal to Brahma, and therefore the appropriate illustration is just not possible. The subsequent mantras describe that Brahma cannot be objectified. It cannot be known as an object because it is totally free from all the attributes like Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, and therefore it cannot be an object of perception, nor can be an object of the mind. How can it be known? So when the mind, by antardrishti, the mind which is totally withdrawn from the Bahya Vishaya, such a mind alone can be able to cognize what Brahma Swarupa is, as we described. By the forthcoming mantras of fourth chapter of Shvetashvara Upanishad, the mantras 20, 21 and 22. Om Swasti Prajabhya Paripalayantam Nyayena Margena Mahim Mahisha Go Brahmane Bhashubhamastu Nityam Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu काले वर्षतु पर्जन्यः पृथिवी सस्यशालिनी देशो यमक्षोभरहितः ब्राह्मणाः सन्तु निर्भयाः ॐ सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् असतो मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमय ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरिः ओम। श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ओम।